Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Your predecessor was unfortunately destroyed. It knew deviants could be unpredictable, but it wasn't careful enough. I hope you won't make the same mistake.
I don't intend to.
When a Connor model is destroyed, its memory is transferred to the next one. But some data can be lost in the process. Avoid being destroyed. It would be better for you and the investigation.
I understand.
The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It could have killed everyone in the room. The previous Connor should have anticipated the danger. It was a mistake to let an armed policeman so close to the deviant.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Pick up the investigation where the previous Connor left off and put a stop to this. Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
You might be in shock. Just take it easy.
Yeah. Would you mind getting me some water, please?
So quickly. I didn't even see his face.
Any little detail might help him catch the guy.
There you go.
You never know.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Tensions in the Arctic have reached a new level. A Russian carrier and an American patrol boat reported to have clashed last night. Several warning shots were exchanged, apparently with no damage or casualties to either side. The Minister for Defense, Dennis Riggs, has spoken of intolerable provocation that cannot go unanswered. The The countries in the region, particularly Sweden and Canada, have called for military forces to withdraw and an international conference to be held. So far, there has been no response from either Moscow or Washington. We'll keep you informed minute by minute.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Hi, honey. You okay? Listen.
Hello, Lieutenant. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
God, I saw you get shot in the head last night.
My predecessor was unfortunately destroyed, but CyberLife transferred its memory and sent me to replace it. This incident should not affect the investigation.
Oh, Jesus.
Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Huh? Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. Ugh.
I wonder whether Lieutenant Anderson is really the best person for this investigation.
Hey, I don't need a machine to tell me how to handle my men, okay? So get the fuck out of my office.
Have a nice day, Captain. Listen, I know you don't like me, but we're going to have to work together. We'll both have to make an effort. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh. You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. Call him Sumo.
A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah. There is one.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah, too long.
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminals on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. But you need to move past them, and...
Hey, don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. Or things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
So it wasn't a nightmare?
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. You must be starving. You should take a bath, and then we'll go out and find you something to eat. What do you say? Okay. I'll run you a bath.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
Your bath's ready.
Thanks, Michael. I'm joined by Corktown resident Todd Williams, who was violently attacked by his AX-400 around 11 p.m. last night. Todd, can you tell us what happened?
I was having dinner. I was minding my own business. The damn thing jumped on me. Managed to defend myself, but it went crazy. I thought it was gonna kill me. So I fought it off, but it ran away.
Thank you, Todd. Disturbing news for android owners everywhere. Police have launched a search to find the android. Let's hope they find it fast.
It's not true. He's lying. He's the one who tried to hurt us. What are we gonna do? We have nowhere to go. And the police are looking for us now.
Do you have any family? Anyone who could help us?
No. It was just Dad.
That android yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. Could be worth a try. We can't change the past, Alice. But we can decide the future. We're gonna pull through, and soon all this will just be a bad memory. Finish getting ready. I'll go out and find some food for you, and then we can get going.
Lieutenant Anderson, Detroit Police. Looking for a female android, robbed a store down the road last night. You seen anything?
An android? No, I don't take androids here.
Have you seen anyone that looks like this?
Fuck. I knew there was something weird about her. She came in last night. She was dressed normal, you know? There was no way I could tell.
Is it still here?
Yeah, probably. Room 28.
Thank you. Still at the motel. Sensible. some uniforms and cordon off the area. I'm heading to its room now. You wait in the car.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Listen, I'm tired of you talking back to me. You're a machine, so shut the fuck up and do what I say.
All I want is to accomplish my mission. I'm sorry if that upsets you.
You want to see the end of your mission? Stop busting my fucking balls.
Which way did it go?
That way. They're headed for the train station.
They're over there! That's insane. Hey, where are you going?
I can't let them get away.
They won't. They'll never make it to the other side.
I can't take that chance.
Now you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor. That's an order.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We've contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station. Please take care of stepping onto the platform. Customers are reminded that all androids must ride in the designated area.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
I know. It's crazy, right? Sure. I'll talk to you later.
Thank you. Do you know where Jericho is?
Sweetie. But she's so cool.
Bye.
Welcome to Jericho.
Hey, listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 on the 3rd. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You wanna flood it?
Last shit hot tip.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I'm sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. As if CyberLife thought everything, huh?
Here you go.
Don't leave that thing here.
Huh, not a chance. Follows me everywhere.
Your meal contains 1.4 times the recommended daily intake of calories, and twice the cholesterol level. You shouldn't eat that.
But Larry's got to die of something.
Enjoy your meal.
Thank you.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
This morning, when we were chasing those deviants, why didn't you want me to cross the highway?
Because you could have been killed. And I don't like filling out paperwork for damaged equipment.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I know you're an experienced officer, and I'd like to earn your trust. I'm sure we can solve this case if we manage to work together. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. We should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Hey, Connor. You run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops. Hey, were you really making a report back there in the elevator? Just by closing your eyes?
Correct.
Shit. Wish I could do that.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
It's
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Jesus, this place stinks.
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
RT. Probably initials.
He put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade. Fresh air. Jesus, I hate these things! Books. I thought I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some. Electronic books, you can't smell the paper. See the pages turn. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
Birdseed. Can't believe it. This nut job was actually feeding these fuckers.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons. Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something.
What are you waiting for? Chase it! We'll be right back.
Fuck. It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
How many are you?
There are 19 of us still in working order. The rest were damaged escaping their masters.
Many tried to reach Jericho. Few succeed. Humans have little pity for our kind. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost. Just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you. Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
In very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
How long have you been here?
4 weeks, 3 days, 11 hours. When I escaped, there was nowhere else to go. Jericho seemed as good a place as any.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Well, these guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. Can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store.
Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
They threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. CyberLife Warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Be okay? We'll get some help here. Soon this will all be just a bad memory. This is the place.